Hi, my name is Umberto Mucci and this is We The Italian News, a podcast about Italy during coronavirus times. Today is Monday, March 29, 2021. The data say that Italy has administered the first dose of the vaccine to 9,444,014 people, 15.5% of the population. 2,969,000 of them received the second dose too. The ranking of the regions by percentage of vaccinations made compared to the doses delivered say that in the first three places from the top are Molise, Veneto and Sicily. In the last three places from the bottom, we continue at least for now, to find the same three regions that have been there for more than a month, Calabria, Liguria and Sardinia. As every Monday, just a few numbers about the situation of the contagion in Italy. Over the past 7 days, with regard to the new positive cases, we averaged a percentage change of -5.4% compared with the previous 7 days. In the same period, the average change in the number of patients admitted to the COVID ward was +4.4%. With regard to intensive care units, instead, in the last 7 days, the average change was +1%. On average, in the last 7 days, we had 427 deaths a day, with a variation of +6.9% compared to the previous 7 days. The minus in the new positive cases is stronger than last week, while the growth in the admissions in the COVID wards and in the ICUs is slowing down, but reached almost the peak, and this means that 12 regions and one autonomous province, as they say, Abruzzo, Emilia-Romagna, Friuli, Venezia Giulia, Lazio, Liguria, Lombardy, Marche, Molise, Piedmont, Puglia, Tuscany, Umbria and the province of Trento, have now more than 30% of ICUs occupied by COVID patients, so exceeding the threshold of alert identified by the Ministry of Health, beyond which the health system goes into crisis. Also, the number of daily deaths is still growing. It is a trend we know. We expect to see in April the acceleration of the descent in the queue of new infections, the minus sign in new hospitalizations and intensive care units, and a little further in the number of daily deaths. The situation is difficult. It is the worst moment of this third wave, but things will get better. Yesterday, the government made some decisions about what will happen in April. Kindergartens, elementary and junior high schools, as to say up to 6th grade, will reopen after Easter, even in regions in the red zone. This is 60% of Italian students. And speaking of schools, a recent study has shown that Italian schools have way too few young teachers, i.e. under 35 years old, just 6.4% in Italy. In Europe, only Greece and Portugal are worse off. More than half of the teachers will retire in the next 15 years. The Italian school world has on its horizon a very strong generational turnover. But if today's conditions do not change in recruitment and training, things will be difficult. Already today, the few young people who teach have contracts that last 1 year at most. 78% of them have precarious jobs. Restrictions will not be loosened, however, regarding the other Italians. Until May, there will be no yellow zones. The government knows well that usually at the end of April, there is a period when Italians are used to go to the countryside or to the sea or to the mountains. Between April 25, the Italian Feast of Liberations, and May 1, which is the Labor Day in Italy, Italians often fanno ponte. That is, they add days off and make sure to have at least a week of vacation. The government wants to avoid that this period, if with fewer restrictions, can become a danger for the resumption of contagion, so it is likely that until the first days of May, the lockdown, more or less hard, will continue throughout Italy. Therefore, until then, probably all over Italy, restaurants will not reopen, not even for lunch, and not even cinemas, theaters or gyms will resume their activities. Another thing announced by the government is that it'll take action against healthcare workers who refuse to be vaccinated against coronavirus, following new reports of infections in hospitals. Prime Minister Draghi said that it's absolutely not good that unvaccinated workers are in contact with sick people. Italy has a small but significant no-vax movement, and some experts fear that numbers may swell following safety fears over the AstraZeneca coronavirus jab. In fact, the percentage of no-vax in Europe is higher in northern countries, while here in southern Europe they are fewer, and even here in Italy they are more in northern Italy than in the south. It seems that 96.5% of healthcare workers have been vaccinated so far in Italy, but it is not certain that all the remaining 3.5% are not vaccinated because they refused it. Many of these workers have already fallen ill with COVID-19, so they may have simply decided to procrastinate vaccination. Europe has officially announced that a vaccine passport will be ready in mid-June. On the document, which will be available in both paper and smartphone versions, there will be a QR code with the date and type of vaccine taken. For those who have not yet or did not want to take the coronavirus vaccine, there will be the result of the last swab taken. According to European authorities, herd immunity from the coronavirus should be achieved in Europe by mid-July, and next summer should be similar to last year thanks to ongoing vaccination campaigns in the European Union. From the medical point of view, there are two good news. For the first time in Italy, two girls were born in recent days with antibodies against COVID-19 at the hospital in Padua, because the two mothers, both doctors, had received the vaccine during pregnancy. In addition, the first trials of monoclonal antibodies produced in Tuscany have given exceptional results. All 22 patients who have received them are cured, all of them. It is still too small a sample, but very encouraging. It is the best result in the world so far on monoclonal antibodies. Now the trial can be extended, and it would represent the first real cure created specifically for COVID. So let's cross our fingers. Please stay safe, stay healthy. My name is Umberto Mucci. This was with Italia News. I'll see you next Wednesday. Ciao from Rome.